Good afternoon from Corfu, Greece. I'll use the full screen now. Okay, first of all, we would like to express our gratitude to the organizing committee for accepting our presentation. When someone comes to Corfu, the first site they should visit is the Old Fortress. It was built by the Venetians during a period from the 15th to the 18th century, and it was considered the masterpiece of fortification at that time. Today, the Public Library and the National Archives of Corfu are housed in this historical monument in a building that was originally used as barracks for soldiers. The Ionian Islands, due to historical circumstances, did not become part of the Ottoman Empire like the rest of Greece. They attracted the interest of the other great powers of that time and became successively part of the Venetian Stato d'Amar, the French Empire, the Russian Empire, and after the Congress of Vienna in 1815, were ceded to the British as a protectorate ruled by a British High Commissioner. This course of events affected not only every aspect of the culture and mentality of the Ionians, but also the ways they preserved their heritage. We can trace the formation of an archival institution and the preservation of documents back to the 15th and 16th centuries, when the Venetian administration appointed a secretary responsible for archiving, preserving, and editing copies of the documents that were kept in the community's archives. Even though the archives of Corfu has suffered many mishaps due to historical circumstances, poor storage, and inadequate preservation, it has not only survived, but has thrived and still has voluminous and interesting material from the 14th century onward. Today, it has achieved a high standard of quality, but it still faces other problems such as the lack of personnel and underfunding. It is estimated that it hosts archival documents that extend to more than 10,000 meters. A very important series of these archives considers the judicial authorities. The criminal court records include trials as far back as 1700. Now a few words about our project. Our research mainly focuses on aspects of violence in Corfu during the period of the British Protectorate, 1815 to 1864, and combines quantitative and qualitative data from the Criminal Court of Corfu. The Criminal Court archives from the period from 1815 to 1864 consist of 270 folders, filice, containing roughly 2,000 subfiles, one for each case, procession. Each subfile includes indictments, depositions, minute books, writs, affidavits, recognizances, inquisitions, calendars, testimonies, bills, transcript of the trial and the verdict, along with the occasional confession. Some of the folders are in a very good condition, but not all of them. We separated the folders that had the inscription Processi Corte Criminale by the first secretary who made the compilation. The cases were not placed in chronological or numerical order. There seems to have been a posterior placement in these folders. For example, you can see this one, they're not in order. The team respected the principles of provenance and original order. As was mentioned, each subfile contains one case. It includes roughly from 20 to 200 or sometimes up to 300 handwritten pages on large sheets of sealed paper, 32 to 44 centimeters, folded in the middle. Sealed paper was purchased especially for the bureaucratic needs of the government. The earliest case files from 1815 to about 1830 did not have covers. From 1830, covers were added. They have the number of the case, you can see it here, the number of the pages up here, the name of the defendant, the name of the plaintiff, the name of the defendant is here, the name of the plaintiff up there on the left, or the ex officio prosecution, the crime, and whether the defendant was under arrest, released or on bail, released on bail or escaped arrest. Inside the file, there is the indictment from the Advocate Fiscal's office that gives the description of the crime and the catalogue of the witnesses and the documents. Criminal court records of Corfu are very detailed. They include transcripts of the whole criminal proceeding, the depositions, the judgment, and the entire documentation and deliberation leading to the judgment. The language used until 1852 was Italian, and after that we find cases in the Greek language. Our team tried to form an index that includes the following: the number of the folder and the subfile, the number of the case, the year of the trial, the name or the names of the plaintiffs, the name or the names of the defendants, the offense or crime as it is described in the indictment, whether there was a bail set for the defendant or they were under arrest, the genders, places of birth, occupations, and ages of the plaintiffs and defendants when mentioned. Here you can see part of the Excel we form with all the data we have collected. Due to the pandemic, which kept everything closed, we were delayed. But so far, we have photographed almost all the indictments, and we have started to collect and categorize the information we obtained. It is the first time such research has been conducted, and our aim is to present the extent of violence in Corfu in the 19th century, the types of crimes or misdemeanors, and the social aspects of violence for both the perpetrators and the victims, which we have found most interesting. Furthermore, our ambition is to give this index and the pictures to the National Archives to be used for the benefit of researchers studying the aspects of social history of this period. Finally, we need to mention that this research is co-financed by Greece and the European Union via the European Social Fund through the operational program Human Resources Development, Education and Lifelong Learning 2014 to 2020. The program anticipated 15 months of work, but due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we received a 4-month prolongation. And now I would like to show you 3 more exceptional pictures from the archives. The first is a voluminous file of 1,464 pages about a case of embezzlement and document falsification. The second one is a drawing from a crime scene from 1835 of the village of Argyrades. And here you can see with an arrow the place where the body was found. And the third one is a monument erected to commemorate that the road was built by the prisoners, by the hard labor of the prisoners. It is in today's Cyprus Street, the place where I live, and they have here the information that it was built in 1854 by the prisoners of the penitentiary. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your attention.